Have you ever heard of zombie deer? These mysterious creatures are wandering through the forests of North America, but could this strange disease cross the species barrier and affect us humans? Join us on this journey to discover the truth behind the zombie deer. In our journey today, we will delve into chronic wasting disease, an alarming phenomenon in the animal kingdom. We will focus on understanding this disease and its possible repercussions. Do you think this disease represents a risk to humans? Keep this question in mind as we explore this mystery. Zombie deer, an imminent threat to humans? Chronic wasting disease, CWD, was first discovered in the late 1960s in deer in Colorado and elk in Wyoming. Since then, it has captured the attention of scientists and conservationists due to its mysterious nature and devastating impact. This disease is caused by prions, abnormal proteins that infect the brains of deer and other cervids. Prions cause normal proteins to fold incorrectly, resulting in progressive brain damage and eventually death. Deer affected by CWD display a range of alarming symptoms: weight loss, lack of coordination, erratic behavior, lethargy, and a distant gaze. These symptoms have earned them the nickname zombie deer. It's important to note that we should not confuse CWD with another condition that affects deer: cutaneous fibromatosis. While CWD is a serious prion disease that affects the brain, cutaneous fibromatosis is a viral condition that causes warts or benign tumors on the skin of deer. Often, people may confuse these two diseases due to the altered physical appearance of the affected animals. However, it is crucial to understand that, unlike CWD, cutaneous fibromatosis is generally not fatal, and in some cases, the warts may disappear over time. Impact on wildlife. Chronic wasting disease, CWD, has become a growing concern in various regions. From its notable presence in Yellowstone National Park, this disease has spread to over 31 states in the United States, spanning from the Midwest Plains to the Atlantic region and the Pacific Coast. Moreover, it has transcended national borders, with cases reported in places as far as Korea and the Philippines. The spread of the disease not only affects animals, but has enormous ecological implications. Hundreds of thousands of deer and elk are part of the natural balance in places like Yellowstone, sustaining predators and scavengers. Wildlife specialists are concerned about the rapid spread of the disease. Without a known method to stop its advance, CWD could destabilize deer populations in large areas. The portrayal of deer affected by an unknown disease in Leave the World Behind resonates strikingly with the actual situation of CWD. This film, produced by Barack Obama, illustrates how fiction can reflect and amplify real concerns. But wait. Before we continue and answer whether the virus can jump species and reach humans, with what we have discovered today, what is your opinion about CWD and its potential impact on us? Do you see any similarities with the plot of Leave the World Behind? See you in the comments. Now let's continue. Risk to humans. Although to date there have been no confirmed cases of chronic wasting disease, CWD, transmission to humans, concern about it persists. The history of other prion diseases, like bovine spongiform encephalopathy, better known as mad cow disease, has taught us that these diseases can, albeit rarely, adapt and cross barriers between different species. CWD mainly affects members of the deer family, but transmission to monkeys, squirrels, and mice with human genes has also been demonstrated. Research is ongoing to assess the risk that CWD might pose to human health. Although some popular press reports have suggested that humans could be affected by CWD, a study by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, indicates that more epidemiological and laboratory studies are needed to monitor the possibility of such transmissions. Given the nature of the disease, which can remain latent in animals before manifesting, there is clear advice for hunters and consumers: exercise extreme caution and avoid consuming deer meat from areas where CWD has been confirmed. This advice is crucial, as early detection in infected animals is complicated. and the disease's latency period makes it difficult to determine if an animal is infected based solely on its appearance. Conclusion. The zombie deer disease is not just a topic of scientific interest, but a wake-up call about our interaction with nature and the potential risks to human health. This case highlights the need for vigilance and preparedness against emerging diseases. What seems like a plot of science fiction is happening in our forests. The spread of chronic wasting is a reminder that nature sometimes writes the most terrifying scripts. If you are interested in this topic, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and activate notifications. See you next time.